I will tonight try to bring you the pictures of the last remaining deer hardy enough to withstand the winter without feed. For a long time, we've expected a grain train from Lincoln to bring grain, but as of this date, it has not shown. Today, I managed to muster the last remaining bits of corn for the poor starving deer, which, as you can already see in previous pictures, have ate my ponderosa pines. Being the only member able to withstand the cold and hardships of the winter here, you can see the last tub of corn we have to offer our Fuhrer. It's my hope that these pictures will reach some sorrowful souls that will bring the needed grain to lend to these starving deer so that they can live through the rest of this hardship of winter. As you can see, the last living squirrel is making an attempt to get the corn before the deer arrive. This being the last male squirrel, I would hope we'll be able to find a female in the spring to replenish our dwindling squirrel supply. you can see, they fight viciously for every morsel of grain. Again, a battle ensues. Only the strong will prevail. Still starving and hungry. The weak have to leave. Fight for their turn to feed. Once again, the weak will try to get in to eat a morsel of grain, but it'll be kept away. few more now approaching have been able to muster enough strength to make it to the woods to the feed. Again, they brutally attack my ponderosa pine. These are the ones that are too weak to make it to green. Some keep coming staggering from the woods off to the west.
This morning I made the mistake of putting the corn out for the deer early. As you can see, the squirrel population is all congregated in our yard. They're eating the corn that was put out for the deer. Chances are I'll have to shoot several of them to save any corn for the starving deer. As you can see, the deer are arriving earlier than usual tonight to try to eat the heartier ones here. Thank you. can see them pawing the ground to get down to some green rye. Squirrel's working fast to stuff himself with corn before the deer come up and run him off. And I can't hear him, but he's raising all kinds of hell. Comes the first deer to challenge the squirrel to the feed. Deer's very leery of me tonight, being so close and not camouflaged whatsoever. Never even come up to the new piles of corn yet. New salt block I put out today. He eyes very suspiciously. Again, he backs off from the salt block. It's challenging, a pile of feed I scraped up from the drop augers. The other deer hanging back, waiting to see if everything will be alright or not. They're not in view at this time. Squirrel still intimidates the deer. Second deer comes up. The bright sunshine and very visible to the deer. Consequently, they're very, very cautious. third one's coming up now. Yes, the others. What the hell's the matter? Squirrel continues to defy the deer. More deer coming to our view now. Extremely cautious tonight. Even their number doesn't defy the squirrel. Squirrel now leaves because he's full, not because he's afraid. only theorize that because of the warmer weather, pangs of hunger aren't near as fierce as they have been before. The deer are far more cautious for their safety. Another squirrel comes back. See, now the one deer has come between me and the feed now. The deer tonight are leaving without eating. There's more deer coming out of the woods now. They haven't come into our scope as of yet. I do not know whether it's sight of me or the pile of feed that they're leery of. More deer continue to come out of the woods, but they're very leery of coming on, pawing through the snow to get the rye that is below. counted 23 deer now. They're out of the woods and feeding through the snow. We must have made a big mistake putting the extra feed out for them. Or order the soybean meal and other medication. Must not be appealing to them. And the squirrel controls the feed bunk. We'll call this squirrel David. Something has frightened the deer. Some of them have returned to the woods. Just no deer brave enough to drive David away. Tonight the squirrel was dominating, running all the deer back into the woods. Maybe at last there's one brave enough to drive him off. And get some corn for his reward. Now another coward comes up. Now three have eaten. More of the cowards come into the picture now. more deer coming out of the woods now, but I'll be in the picture. Don't show in the picture of the camera, there are 29 deer that I can view. Some of the deer started eating in the cracked corn and so forth. Fell out of the feed hole.
I don't know how clear the picture will be. I'm trying to get a wider angle to pick up even more of the deer. Deer come out of the woods to the east, they scratch in the rye, get some rye, come up here and get a few morsels of corn. Move on to the west, circle out in the field, and back towards the woods. And I've crawled on them through the trees. The snow was cold. the larger group of deer between here and the woods. They seem very hesitant to come on out. I do not know how clear these pictures will be. It's getting rather dark. More deer coming out of the woods. But the excruciating cold is cutting into my bones, and I will be forced to stop recording. Some of the deer continue to gnaw on the remaining stalks of my ponderosa pine. These deer had the courage of David the squirrel, I'd be in great danger. forced to discontinue at this time.